How challenging, if at all, did you find it to bring in new athletes to work with post-Balco?
It's very challenging.
What's most challenging about it?
Well, when I see, as an example, let's just say a husband would very much like to work with me, but the wife says, listen, you know, you need to not associate with this guy because you don't want this taint upon you. Others that are willing to be open about it, and some choose to work with me, but have this be kept just between us. And there are those that have been threatened or given opportunities. Dwayne Chambers is an example where they basically demanded that he come forward publicly and announce that he had terminated his relationship with me. Dwayne says in his own book that, you know, he's like a son to me and I'm like a father figure to him. And we're very close and always have been, and I'm sure we always will be. But publicly, you know, he was forced by the governing body of track and field there in the UK to publicly announce that he was terminating his relationship. And there are others that the media, you know, questions why the athlete would trust me, why the athlete would work with me. You know, there have been those that have said lots of things that, you know.
How would you respond to those criticisms?
I understand them. I really do. It's something that I don't think that I will ever completely overcome this. It's a challenge on a daily basis, and I really enjoy being in the trenches working with athletes, and it's just a part of my past, and that will be with me for the rest of my life, and I'm going to have to accept that some people are willing and able to find forgiveness in their hearts, and others are not willing to do so. I mean, I think that, you know, forgiveness is very important for people to learn. And what I've learned is it's very difficult to learn to forgive yourself.
Why do you say that?
Because you feel responsible and you feel guilty. And you know, especially when the damage that has been done is of the magnitude, as in the case of Balco and what happened there. I mean, some consider that to be the 9/11 of sport.